Hey guys, welcome back to my book channel. So today I'm going to be doing a whole slew of videos, 9 videos in total, and I'm going to be recommending books, fiction and nonfiction, for each Enneagram type. Now, I'm a huge Enneagram fan. I've been an Enneagram fan for a long time now. I feel like I know the Enneagram really, really well. I've read an entire book about it, and it's just something that I'm really fascinated in, and it's something that I just love to research and learn about, and I just think it's a really, really interesting thing. So I feel like I will do a pretty good job with this, and I think it's gonna be really, really fun. Don't take it too seriously. Like, the Enneagram, just like anything, is just a theory, it's just an idea. It's just something to kind of have fun with, to look into and kind of learn a little bit more about yourself and things like that. But from learning about the Enneagram and really studying it as much as I have, I definitely feel like there's a lot of truth to the Enneagram. I'm not saying it's the absolute truth, but there is a lot of truth to it. If you guys haven't taken your Enneagram test, I will definitely leave a couple links down below. I would definitely take your top three that you get and maybe go research those top three and kind of decide for yourself which one you feel like matches you the best. For me, whenever I take the Enneagram test, I always get an Enneagram 5, but through self-reflection, I've learned that I'm actually an Enneagram 9, wing 1. So I don't want to get into too much discussion about the Enneagram, but I'm going to also link down below the video that I made on my main channel all about the Enneagram. I talk about each number and kind of the core fears, core motivations, and core desires of each number. So with all that said, let's go ahead and just jump right in. Okay guys, now for my Enneagram 3 video. I'm having so much fun filming these videos, you guys. Like, it's my two favorite things, the Enneagram and books. I'm like having the time of my life today. So let's go ahead and talk about the Enneagram 3. Now, I used to think I was an Enneagram 3 for a little bit, and I think there's some elements that I see in myself that relate to the Enneagram 3, but I think it's because as a 9, when we're healthy 9s, we show the healthy aspects of a 3, and so I think that's why I relate a little bit to the 3. But I actually know a lot of 3s in my life, so I have some really good book recommendations for you. The Enneagram 3 is the Achiever. You're a success-oriented, and you're the pragmatic type. You're adaptable, excelling, driven, and image-conscious. When 3s are in stress, they can show the unhealthy levels of a Enneagram 9. When 3s are in growth or healthy, you can show the healthy aspects of a 6. So the basic fear of the Enneagram 3 is of being worthless or like unsuccessful. The basic desire is to feel valuable and worthwhile, successful. The Enneagram 3 with a 2 wing is the charmer, and the Enneagram 3 with a 4 wing is the professional. The key motivation is to want to be affirmed, to distinguish themselves from others, to have attention, to be admired, and to impress others. So yeah, that is the basic Enneagram 3. So this is definitely my number one pick for Enneagram 3. If you're an Enneagram 3, you have to read this book. I repeat, have to read this book. Not only do I think any number would love this book because it's just a fantastic book, but specifically Enneagram 3s, because the main character in this book is such a 3, and it is perfect. Like, you guys have to read this, I'm telling you. It is The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. So this book is about a woman who gets into the acting industry at a very young age. She decides she wants to go into acting, and she does whatever she possibly can to make it to the top of her acting career. She wants to be successful, she wants to be at the top, and she will do anything she can to be a successful actress. Now, in this book, it talks about her 7 husbands. It talks about her balancing her relationships with her career, and then it is basically her whole life story. And then at the end, it kind of talks about where she's at looking at her life and the mistakes that she made and what she would have done differently. There's elements in this book where she definitely falls into the unhealthy levels where she puts her career above all else, and she does everything that she possibly can to make it to the top and to be successful to the point where she hurts relationships. And she definitely puts people that she cares about on the back burner to achieve the things that she needs to achieve. She marries people just to advance her career. Like, I can't explain how much this book affected me. As somebody that goes to 3 in health, like, I can see elements of this book, and maybe that's why it affected me so much, because it's just done in such a beautiful way. Like, it's not cliche. It's very, 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 very well done. And I think that all 3s will benefit from this, because I think it will put into perspective the important things in life and things that you might be putting on the back burner. And it's just so good. I can't explain it. It just shows, like, how I think an Enneagram 3 can have regrets in life. And I think if you read this now, you might be able to look at your own life and say, okay, interesting. Do I have some of these traits? Do I have some of these qualities? And You may not. You may be a very healthy three that's able to balance things out well. She's the most realistic character in the fact that you love and hate her at the same time. And I think Enneagram threes will be able to see their good qualities, but also their not so good qualities. So you see both in her. And so I think that it'll be almost like looking in a mirror sometimes in this book. And so I think that this is just, it's a must, guys. I'm telling you, threes, read this. So the next book is The Shadows Between Us by Trisha Levenseller. So the main character in this book is a three, 100% a three. And I honestly think both characters are kind of three-ish in a way. But this is basically about a girl who wants to be the queen. And she's gonna do whatever she can to be the queen. And that includes killing the king, marrying him first, and then killing him so she can be the queen. So this is just a very, very fun, quick, short, to the point fantasy. It's not a series, it's just a short, quick fantasy. Not a lot of world building, not a lot of that, but it's really fun because this character is a three. She's an evil three. She's not a very, like, moral three, but she's a three. And so I think that you'll have fun reading this because it's definitely a, like, book that you might be able to, like, relate to. Not that you would do this, but I think that you might see that really strong, driven quality in yourself. Like, she's definitely strong, she's driven, she's gonna do whatever she can to see her goals through. She's goal-oriented, and she's gonna do what she can do. Next up is Vicious by V.E. Schwab. Now, I don't really think that there's a three in this book, to be honest. I don't think that either of the main characters or the main villains in this book are threes, but the reason I picked this book is because I think that threes can relate, I think, a little bit to these characters. So these are about two guys that are in college, and they discover a way to make extraordinary people, or people with, like, mutant powers, you know, special powers. They figure out how to make these people, and in the process they decide they want to make themselves extraordinary people. So they do what they have to do to get their powers, and then they basically start disagreeing on whether or not extraordinary people should exist, should they not exist, what their power should be used for, and they start disagreeing on these things to the point where they become enemies, and they basically want to kill each other. So it's a really, 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 really good book, amazing read, but I think that what's cool about this is you see both of the characters have their idea of what they believe is right, and they are going to do anything that they can to see their goals and ideas and theories through, and they're extremely driven people, and they're kind of one of those people that aren't, they're gonna stop at nothing. I think that a lot of threes can relate to these characters probably. They're very charismatic, which is a big one as well, and I think especially Eli in this book is a very charismatic guy. I just think that this book, even though the characters aren't threes, I think that threes would really enjoy this because I think that it shows just drive and it shows ambition. It just screams three to me for some reason, I don't know. So the last recommendation I have for Enneagram threes is An Absolutely Remarkable Thing by Hank Green. Now, the reason that I recommend this book is because sometimes I feel like Enneagram threes, not all threes, I'm not saying every three fits into these categories, but sometimes threes can become a little bit too obsessed with, you know, their reputation, their worth when it comes to, you know, their reputation or their social media accounts, the numbers, you know, likes, comments, whether or not they're putting off the right impression and things like that. And I think that sometimes when you get into an unhealthier state, like those worries, like if you do see your likes go down or you do see numbers go down or you're not getting enough comments, sometimes that can put a damper on you. And I think that sometimes social media can be a catalyst for feeling worthless, because that is a fear of Enneagram 3s, is not being successful. And so this book really goes into the problems with social media and the problems with internet fame and social media fame and what that can do and what effects that has on people and kind of the stress that it can bring to a person. And I think that it really shows the importance of finding a balance and understanding that your worth is not numbers, your worth is not how popular you are on social media, how famous that you are. The girl in this book does become social media famous and it really starts to affect her life, and she starts to kind of like feed off of it in a way. Once you realize that your mood is being affected by that and your stresses are being affected by that, you can make changes to, you know, realize that you need balance and that your worth is not contingent upon how many followers and likes and comments that you're getting. And I think that just in general, in this day and age and in society, that it's a really easy thing to fall into, not just for threes, but for everybody. But for threes specifically, because it is kind of their biggest fear. So I hope these books sound good to you guys. If you are a Enneagram 3 and you've read any of these books, please let me know if you agree with the recommendations, if you like the recommendations, and or if you didn't like them, or you don't agree. I'd be interested to hear that as well. And I hope that you guys find these books entertaining and fun to read, and you see yourself in these, and you can grow and learn and become a better person, maybe. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!